So we will start with a short 2-minute video and we will take it from there. So, oh, did something wrong here, I apologize.
It's your land, and you know it better than anyone. Every crop, every ditch, every plant. You also know that adaptive irrigation is the key to getting the most out of your soil. These sensors give you the simplest, smartest, and best adaptive irrigation solution. It's completely do-it-yourself. You'll be up and running in no time. The revolutionary spiral design allows for easy installation and perfect results.
It's irrigation with a difference. CropX combines advanced cloud technology with affordable sensors in the ground. Unique CropX technology scans your field and analyzes its different zones. The CropX mobile app directs you to the exact point in your field to place the sensor in the soil. Simply scan the QR code and the sensor automatically connects to the system, starts gathering data, and sending it to the cloud. Now that your fields are connected online, expect to receive texts from them. Your fields now have a voice.
So, Dad, what's your field saying today?
No need to water today.
The CropX system automatically generates the optimal irrigation plan and sends it to the app for you to approve or modify.
Adaptive irrigation works for me.
Hey, Dad, the field's texting you.
Yes, you can now tend to your field anywhere, anytime. Rest easy while CropX monitors your field and optimizes crop yields. Skeptical? Try it on just one pivot and see for yourself.
CropX, the internet of soil.
So if only life was so simple as in the video. When we started CropX about 5 years ago, the idea was to revolutionize and automate the farm. And we essentially looked at the three major categories of questions that a farmer needs to answer almost on a daily basis. Those would be irrigation management, on one hand, fertilizer management, and the third would be crop protection. Crop protection meaning pesticides, chemicals, spraying, and so forth. Now, looking at the data and the insights that was available to farmers at the time, it was kind of shocking to see that 90% of the companies that were providing answers to these three big questions were bringing their data from above the ground, solely from above the ground. When I say above the ground, I mean satellite imagery. I mean UAVs, drones, a camera that you would put on a weather station or a camera that you put on a tractor. And less than 10% of the companies were bringing data from within the soil, which is where agriculture really happens. Now, it's obvious why, because satellite is much more accessible, and in-ground sensing, I mean, the ground data is the most difficult to extract, but it is also the most valuable. Now, when you come to do pest control, for example, I mean, yes, you've got to do that from above the ground. You've got to see exactly what's on the crop in order to be able to spray properly. But if you try to do irrigation management or fertilizer management from above, you're going to miss the beat. You're always going to be coming in too late, essentially looking in the rearview mirror. Like take, for example, a plant that's not receiving enough fertilizer. Such a plant would suck up everything that it can from the root zone and from the stem, and by the time it shows something above the ground on the leaves, 2 weeks would have passed and it's just too late. And we at CropX, coming from within the ground with our insights, we can be predictive, we can be preventive. We know that a plant is not receiving enough water even before the plant knows. And that's what CropX was all about. So essentially being the first company to provide insights from the ground or bottom up. So we first started by taking soil sensors, third-party soil sensors like many people do, connecting them to our system, but nothing worked. Nothing was good enough because you need something that should scale. You got to have something to scale because you want all of this data. And you need something that comes at the right price point. And above all, you need something that would be accurate. So we ended up developing our own, developing the best soil sensor in the world today. This piece that I have here right now. So this thing is the only do-it-yourself soil sensor. It's installed by the farmer in just 5 minutes, like you've seen in the movie. Compare that to other technologies that are out there, typically take half a day or more to install by a technician, so they can't scale. Also, in terms of pricing, when you look at technologies that are out there today, many of them come at $50 or $85 per acre, which is just not relevant. A corn grower in the United States makes a net profit of $100 per acre per year, so he's not going to deploy anything at 50 and certainly not at 85. This thing today comes at $1 per acre per month, so it's the only thing that's really relevant for the mass market, the commodity crops. It can really go anywhere. In terms of connectivity, it can connect anywhere. Connectivity, by the way, is a huge, huge issue for IoT devices on the field. But most importantly, if we're targeting to kind of have a big data play from data coming from the soil, the data has got to be accurate, because otherwise it's garbage in, garbage out. And the vast majority of the sensors today are really skewing and distorting the results. When you put something like this in the ground, you get water flowing alongside the sensor. So it's called preferential flow, essentially 200% miss on accuracy just by doing that. And we were able to solve this by our patented technology. The fact that we sense here on the spiral, we get 200% more accuracy than anything else. So that's the hardware part, essentially the best device in the world to collect data. But the truth is that the brain is in the software. 70% of the company today are software developers, machine learning developers, big data scientists. And so a farmer essentially downloads the app, says, hey, this is my field. We analyze it for him. And we have all of the various data streams coming into the system. Yes, we have satellite, we have weather, we have the crop models, we have topographical data, we have USDA data in the United States. Everything gets crunched in the system in order to provide the best insights for customers. And we're able to tell the customer today how to irrigate, when to irrigate, how to fertilize, even crop protection. So essentially the first do-it-yourself farm management system that really closes the loop from ground sensing, real-time ground sensing, to automation. And in that respect, just like take the third screenshot, the one that shows the satellite image. So I'll just dig in here a little bit with a real example. So what does everybody do? You take a satellite image, very easy, totally accessible, and you look at the field every day and you look for changes in the image. Once you spot an image, you essentially can tell the farmer, hey, you know, there's something going on there, go check. And he goes to the field and he checks and he sees that there is a pesticide outbreak. So either by walking the field or by sending a drone, and then he goes sprays. At this point, it's too late. It's all about just containment and making sure that it doesn't go anywhere else. But our system that also has kind of a foot on the ground, we have sensors. We start finding correlation and learning. So after learning from thousands of such examples, we actually seen that when this happens, the plants actually, the water uptake is different, because plants that are stressed, they don't drink water the same way that plants, healthy plants do. So now we could be predictive, and when we spot a certain pattern in water uptake, we can say, hey, something's going on there. And in a week, you're going to see it on a satellite image as well. This is a huge experiment that we did on a pivot in Arizona. Our system controlled a pivot. By the way, a pivot is 125 acres, 500 dunams. That's like the size of an average neighborhood in Israel. We controlled this for a year. Okay, the slices that you see like on the pizza, so our system controlled the slice, the farmer controlled the slice. We controlled the slice, the farmer controlled the slice. So A-B testing for ag, we proved here that our system saved 40% of the water and increased yield by 10%. We started selling 2 years ago. Installations are going great, mostly in the United States initially, now all over the world. We're totally crop agnostic. We're not even in irrigation necessarily anymore. So commodity crops, high value crops, berries, vegetables, what have you. In terms of the use cases, and I see that my time is running short, so very exciting to see that so many of our farmers are using CropX for so many different reasons. And I'll just give one as an example out of this entire thing here. Energy. So turning that pivot around costs about $500 per day, because it's huge. So we have about 30% of our customers putting CropX in the ground and saying, hey, you know, I see that I can stop the pivot because I have enough water in the ground. They stop the pivot for 1 day, and they already paid for our system a year in advance. We had farmers that got 10x ROI in the first year just based on that. And we have a great team, you'll have to believe me. And a great team is also a great syndicate of investors. So investors such as Innovation Endeavors, that's Eric Schmitz, Google's former chairman, his personal fund, invested in CropX because of the big data, because of the AI vision. Finisterre Ventures, the best VC in the United States for ag. Green Soil, the same in Israel. Here we also have our crowd leading the bunch. And as you see, many strong strategics as well. Last thing, now that my time is up, so Tmurah, we are a Tmurah donor. Tmurah, for those of you who don't know, are a nonprofit organization. They get a donation, a small ESOP donation from startups, and then when you have an exit, they take the money and they donate it to charity and very good means and causes. So for those startups here, please join the program. Thank you very much.